In this video, I'll be explaining basic anatomy of biceps brachii. I will explain its origin, insertion, function, and important thing about biceps brachii. Let's look at the origin of biceps brachii first. It has two attachments. That's why this muscle is called biceps brachii, two heads. This red tape represents long head. This blue tape represents short head. Let's look at origin of long head. It attaches on the scapula. It's very close to shoulder joint. This point is called supraglenoid tubercle. You don't have to remember the typical name, but you just remember it's very close to shoulder joint. And this blue one, the short head of biceps attaches on the coracoid process. This is part of scapula as well. So both long head and short head originate from scapula. And it kind of runs this way, this way, this way, and unifies, and it inserts here. This bone is radius on the forearm bone. This typical part is called radialtuberosity. And some fibers attaches on the fascia of forearm. Biceps brachii attaches on both bone and fascia. So if biceps brachii pulls arm this way, it can pull fascia this way as well. So main function of biceps brachii. What is the most famous function of biceps? It's elbow flexion, right? It does a flexion for elbow joint. This is very strong elbow flexor. This is very famous, right? Not only that, it can do other movement of elbow joint, which is supination. Supination is a movement of wrist. So let's look at on my arm. Biceps brachii does flexion. See how my biceps brachii shortens up? And if I supinate, it shortens up even more. I'll go back to neutral. It's lengthened, relaxed. Elbow flexion shortens up, and supination shortens even more. So, biceps brachii does elbow flexion and supination. Supination is this way. Remember, palm faces up. So this is the function of biceps brachii for elbow joint. Remember, both short head and long head close shoulder joint. Why? Because these guys start from scapula. That means these guys do shoulder movement. I will explain that. Both short head and long head do shoulder flexion. Raise arm this way. This is shoulder flexion. Actually, short head only does flexion, but long head does more. You see, long head runs like this, up, 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 and goes lateral and attaches on supraglenoid tubercle. So this part is kind of going this way, right? This way. So long head can do abduction. Abduction is you open up arm this way. This is abduction. And also this can do slight internal rotation. Internal rotation this way, right? Long head is very important for abduction. One anatomy book says if long head loses completely the function, it will decrease 20% of total power of abduction. That's a lot, right? 20% is quite a big number. If this loses a complete function, you lose 20% of abduction power. So this is very important. And one more thing about biceps brachii long head. I said this is very close to shoulder joint. Yes, this is very close to shoulder joint. What do I mean? long head actually penetrates joint capsule of shoulder. Joint capsule is like a innermost supportive system. It's kind of wrapping around joint. So long head penetrates this joint capsule. Sounds very interesting, doesn't it? So if biceps brachii long head got tightness here or got tear, ruptures or numbness, any kind of dysfunction, it may affect shoulder joint itself. Why? Because this penetrates shoulder joint capsule. Sounds very interesting. I want you to remember, biceps is not only for elbow muscle, but this is also important for shoulder joint because they can do a shoulder flexion, abduction, and internal rotation. Long head is very close to shoulder joint. So this is today's video. If you liked it, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.